For the big debate tonight, a tape surfaces, one that Tucker Carlson's conservative website, The Daily Caller, bills as Obama's other race speech. A clip.
These quiet riots that take place every day are born from the same place as the fires and destruction and the police decked out in riot gear and death. They happen when a sense of disconnect settles in and hope dissipates. Despair takes hold and young people all across the country look at the way the world is and they believe that things are never going to get better.
Carlson called this a bombshell, but little reality here. This tape is not new. It was an open press event recorded in its entirety in 2007. And many media outlets, including CNN, extensively covered it. Even Tucker Carlson himself covered it in 2007 when he worked for MSNBC.
Barack Obama was talking about a quiet riot today, and no, it was not a reference to the 1980s heavy metal band, unfortunately. The senator waded into the controversial waters of race during a speech at Hampton University in Virginia. He said the Bush administration has done little to quell a brewing storm among some black Americans. He compared the current tension to what fueled the L.A. riots.
In fact, even CNN's headline that day read like this, Obama quiet riot could erupt like L.A. riots. Joining me now to talk about this is the co-editor of Mother Jones magazine, Monica Bauerlin. Good morning, Monica.
Good morning, Carol.
So your site is, of course, now famous for releasing Mitt Romney's, that secret videotape of Mitt Romney talking about the 47%. I just wondered, you know, your reaction to this video that was kind of like pumped up on the Drudge Report, and then it was released on the Daily Caller, and then it made its way to Fox News. Take me through the thought process, as far as you can tell, of this release of this tape.
Well, one of the things I would surmise, and obviously I'm not inside, you know, the Daily Caller's operations, is that ever since our Mitt Romney video made news, everybody else has been looking around for other videos of the candidates appearing in small settings or years ago, being more candid than they might be in public today. And I think we're seeing some of the results as people dig up videos that have not been seen lately. Of course, you know, as you pointed out, this particular Obama speech was widely covered at the time, so it's not really the equivalent of, for instance, the video we released that hadn't been seen before.
I was going to ask but you, everybody like, how would you compare the tapes?
Well, in both cases, you know, we see the candidate being a little more unvarnished than we see them on the campaign trail. The campaign trail personas that we see are very scripted, very sanitized. What Obama is saying in that video doesn't sound nearly as revelatory to me. I mean, those are, you know, the kinds of things that candidates say during primary campaigns that are a little more passionate and emotional than they are necessarily during the general election. But it's not, again, it's not really the equivalent of this small group Romney video that had him saying things that he would not really be found saying in public.
It seems like, you know, as campaigns become more and more scripted, that sites like yours and maybe news organizations are going to try to find these tapes where the candidate is talking off the cuff.
Well, our site, of course, is a news site. You know, we are all about the journalism. We found this video through the investigative reporting efforts of our D.C. bureau chief, David Korn. And yes, I think, you know, every journalist and every candidate learned or should have learned back in 2008 with the Makaka moment involving, you know, former Senator George Allen, that there is video of everything. If there were more than two people present at a gathering, there's video of it, and somebody's putting it on YouTube, and somebody's going to find it and post it.
So the 47% thing that appeared on Mother Jones, I mean, how often do you think that President Obama will mention that in tonight's debate?
47 times. you know, you know, we could not quite have expected the impact it would make, but I think what it has done is really put Mitt Romney in a position of debating with himself, because at this point people are seeing the Romney who's speaking to them on the stump and in tonight's debate and in commercials, and in their heads they're also seeing the man who's speaking to a group of people who paid $50,000 to get in, and they have to make up their minds really which one of them they believe.
Monica Bauerlin from Mother Jones, thank you so much for joining.